Hi everyone, Steve here. Welcome back to another devlog of Veloce. Since the last devlog, I made a few new cars. The Envoy, a four-wheel drive hot hatch based on the Mark IV Escort Cosworth. The Burrow, a front-wheel drive hatchback based on the fourth generation Honda Civic, mixed with the rock climbing abilities of the Dragonborn. And the Instra, a car that's based on the Acura Integra, but for some reason this car feels really off to me. Can you see what's the issue with it? Because honestly I can't. Now that we have three working cars, one RVD, one FVD and one AVD, I can finally fine-tune them. You can see that I'm going for a specific era here. These cars are from the late 80s, early 90s. I'm planning to make 6 cars from this era, all powered roughly equally, then 6 cars from the 2000s that are slightly faster, 6 from the 2010s and finally 6 from the 2020s for a total of 24 cars. But the majority of the devlog will not be about the cars, but rather a how-to on track making in Godot. You see, this is what I spend most of my time on. From the start, I used an herb cycle in Blender to create a track, and it was a smooth track. Nicely, naturally bending curves, just as I wanted. I just had to make sure not to do too many sharp turns. It was looking really good. But then, disaster struck. As I want to keep the track's length to around 2-3 minutes on a 90s car, I had to keep the track relatively large, around 3 or 4 kilometers in length. That brought up an issue with performance, because the whole track was one large object with a lot of trim mesh collision, and this was really heavy on my PC. Well, okay, what if I use the built-in pass system of Godot to create the track? I follow Bastian's tutorial on how to create a track using the CSG polygon. It worked fairly correctly. It was essentially the same because it still created a track along a path, but I had an issue with editing the track itself in Godot because I couldn't move the control points as easily as I could have in Blender, so I couldn't create elevations. So as fast as this method came to create tracks, it went just as quickly. I went back to my original Blender made track and simply cut my track into pieces. This is my last resort. And while this worked, it increased my workload greatly. I was essentially dependent on the Blender file to contain everything I needed, but with a small change in the path, everything would have to be exported out once again. So finally I landed on track pieces that are just straights, bends, ramps and so on that I can easily snap together. Just like for example in Trackmania. This method had a lot of pros and honestly just a few cons. The pros of building a track from track pieces is that it's faster in performance than the nerf path. I can be built easily, creating an in-game track editor would be easy and also necessary, and finally there is a possibility to have infinite random generated tracks. The cons of this method is that the tracks would either need a lot of different pieces or they would feel very similar to each other. Another con of this is the workload now shifted towards the start of the development. Imagine that this line is the development time for tracks. For the sake of this explanation, it doesn't really matter how many tracks I want. If I want to go with the NURBS piece track, my workload will look something like this. You can see how every track would take roughly the same amount of time to make, because each time I would have to build the track from the ground up in Blender. Sure, I get better with Blender in time, but the core concept of building would stay the same. Now compared to the modular tracks, my workload would look something like this. You can see it spikes on the second track because after the first one is done, I have to make a track editor. Now that I know what I need in order to create a track, this would in the long run be faster than just building the track from the Godot engine itself. I also believe that this modular track method would create the same level of quality of tracks as with the NURBS method, but it would be much faster. That's all for this devlog. Join me next time when I try to figure out how AIs in racing games work. But until then, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and hit the bell as well. You can follow me on Twitter to get more detailed explanation of the work on Veloce. See ya!